Somewhere between ground level and mountain top lies the answer to the question why we climb. But are we deliberately looking for that answer? Or do we seek something that is yet still unknown to ourselves? Sometimes we learn something new about the past that changes everything we know about the present.
My name is William Kosher, proud resident of the Baronies in the Hautes Pyrenees. The life I am living is a simple one, yet I have to make many complicated decisions. And sometimes I do not know how to find the balance between what I want, what is needed, and what could be. When I choose to go into the mountains, it can mean so many different things. It can become a lifestyle. It can be purely recreational. It can be a profession. How can I distinguish them from one another? am a father. I am a climate activist. And I am a skier.
Ay, Wiru!
Today is not the day. Not for me. It seems time is causing trouble. There is something on my mind. Something I need to figure out. Skiing makes me feel good. But it also covers up the underlying problem of not always being able to take care of the environment. I think I have a passion crisis. Back in the days, life was more simple. I think living close to nature brings back some of that simplicity. It brings back the natural flow of life. In a time where things go so fast, it is important to be able to slow down. The world changes from year to year. Our lives from day to day. But memories will never pass away.
Some lives have already set a course. When you are born a shepherd, you live a life of courage. When you're a smuggler crossing the mountains, you become a hunted beast. When you're a geographer deciding to climb his first peak and then the next, your future is unknown. How can they not feel alive?
The Pyrenees will always bring two countries together and divide them at the same time. Before, life was about survival, about what was really needed and finding practical ways to get it. Now, without a doubt, you become someone that accomplished something. Leisurely. Thank you. From time to time, you will not know the value of a present moment until it becomes a memory.
How do we want to be remembered? It is not the mountains we conquer. It is ourselves. Guided by geographers, smugglers, or shepherds, are writing a new, less harsh history. This wild world then becomes poetry. Once, we were nurtured by nature. Our need to seek for serenity derives from it. We can see change, not only in ourselves, but also around us. With every step we take, one receives far more than he seeks. Nature is breathing the air we need. When we leave the daily routine behind, it opens up our minds. Whether it is climbing up a mountain or sleeping under the stars, we examine, we observe, consider, recognize, and glance at things that once were, things that are, and things that will be. Step by step, vision turns into reality. Every yesterday becomes a memory of today.
Winter is coming. I'm going to change my approach. My way. My way towards the mountains. And the one of getting closer to nature.
Every step is a transition from one change to another. The landscape changes from green to white. From light to dark. From warm to cold. We change too. With every step, different emotions arise. Whether we feel tired, joy, or motivation, the mountains can make us feel more alive. The world, nature, changes. One day, the glacier touches these caves. Tomorrow, the ice will be gone. History hides many stories that have not been told yet. But there are plenty that we gladly relive.
And me? What can I say? I need to do better to make today as important as tomorrow.
We tend to look back and forth between past, present, and future. Maybe we do feel the same longing for freedom, and maybe we do find it in nature, like people did in the past. But can we adjust as easily to nature? Now we know what the present has to offer. The ability to reach further, to go higher, to do better, could and should be much easier now. Your present circumstances do not determine where you can go. They merely determine where you start. Each day, you have to make a decision. Will you give up, give in, or give it all? For. Life teaches us to make good use of time. Time tells us the value of life. At the start of the day, everything is still possible. Your feet carry you towards your end goal, while your mind sets on where you want to go. But if there is no struggle, there will be no progress. From now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than the things you did do. behind every cloud, the sun still shines. You can't know everything, but you can prepare for what might come. Patience is not about the ability to wait, but about the ability to keep the right attitude while waiting.
잠깐만 아 아니야 떠오른 그 말
Nature is not a place to visit. It is home. To live in it requires skills, dedication, creativity, audacity, and a willingness to adapt to the forever changing environment. We feel safer when we can get the things we need to live a simpler life. But it sounds paradoxical. Get more to have less. Yet it is all about the choices you make. If what you need is not available, search for the closest thing possible and use what you already have. Forward to making a change, to take one step forwards, even when it means I have to take two steps backwards first. The change I make is maybe not one for everyone, but for me, it works. For now. And I realize that if I want to be fully responsible for my actions, fully committed to my environment, I have to do more. I have to do better. Now I have to let go of one part of myself to make space for another.
There is nothing more uncertain than our future. Nothing more certain than the past. What once was lost is not lost. It is written in history. And like the present and the future, history can also be explored.
Fears. Thank you.